Legend of Total War here with part 15 of my Total War Medieval 2, it's the wrong order, of Let's Play Campaign as Venice. Previously, I don't know, we've been fighting everyone. Pretty much everyone, let me have a look here. Who am I not at war with? Russia, basically people who I haven't met yet. Yeah, that's right, we had a good call on Hungary there, that was great. Alright, what else do I need to do? Alright, we've got this. What are we up against? This is a wooden castle. I hate wooden castles. But luckily not too many troops in there. Got plenty of money, but I really don't think I should. Oh, I'm addicted to more troops. My lord, should we spare any of them? Nah, I can't be bothered. We tore them apart, my lord. Victory! Probably took more casualties than I would have liked there, but we're okay. Oh, it just got a little bit lazy. I just came back from like playing a little bit of Total War Warhammer, so naturally, I guess I'm auto resolve crazy. So, okay, I gotta reel back into Medieval 2 style. Anyway, that battle wouldn't have been interesting. Alright, so Alexandria is just up here. Yep, let's go assault it. I don't mind assaulting minor cities, I just don't like large towns. Towers are very powerful. Excuse me. Alright, so how are we going over here? We've besieged this, whether or not they do anything about it, I guess we'll see. Okay, now we could just get straight onto the ship, or we could kill two town militia. Name thy enemy, Lord. I don't see the need to kill the two town militia. I mean, where they are standing right now is not going to block much of our income at all. And yeah, it's just going to waste my movement. Want them to go to Bordeaux and pick up some more ships. The remnants of the Portuguese are there. Let me strike, my lord. Okay, now the Pope is playing ball. That's good. Still got my merchant here. So, if he was making 113 per turn for 25 turns, that's 2,500, which it's not really very much. Your orders, number one. But if I had taken him down to the gold, I'd make even less because it's close to the capital. Name thy enemy, Lord. Suppose we could make Rome the capital now. Let's see if that makes me more money. It does. Now, is that negatively going to affect our public order? Only in Edessa. Well, just some priests here will sort out. It's probably mostly Islamic. Yeah, or Orthodox. Just as bad. No, that's garbage. Probably best build a town watch. That'll increase law. They're going to need a hurry with this because that triumph bonus is going to keep going down. Now we'll sort it out. Okay, so we took Mosul recently. This army is really not in good shape now. Might keep them here for a little while and just recruit a few more troops. Actually, I'll get the small chapel there first. Actually, no, I'm going to get garrison quarters. Changing my mind. Alright, so who haven't I moved yet? Your orders, number one. Orders? March. Yeah, it would be all rebels out here. This is where we motherfucker. And it's a wooden castle, too. Alright, let's do this a different way. Ah, damn it, piece of shit. So I was thinking if I could just besiege that with like a couple of troops, I'd easily beat that because it's all bloody infantry. But yeah, and it couldn't be there because then it'd be within that would actually detect this within reinforcement range, even though it wouldn't. So yeah, fucked that up there a little bit. Okay, there doesn't seem to be anything else to do, so I'm going to construct things. So yeah, just building a lot of farmland because, I think it's good. Alright, so Bucharest is a town. Probably best I lower the tax rate here because we need to double the population. So you might be wondering, why am I building all this farmland? Population growth. You just gotta trust me with this. Some people always like, well, not always like that. Some people ask me, why am I always building this? Why am I always building that? And I'm just like, well, just let me play the game how I want to fucking play it, alright? I think I've earned that right. Alright, that'll do. Let me just check the public order of all regions. Yeah, we're okay. Let me just say that again. This region here, Kiev. Yeah, okay, so we don't have much money. We're just waiting on, the next crusade. That'll make us some more cash. But we're sitting on 61 territories, which means there's only 45 settlements left mainland Europe. Alright, let's move on. I'm sure there was something I forgot to do. But it's not like it's going to be game-breaking. These hostilities with the Holy Roman Empire. Well, you had to bloody go and do that, didn't you? You dick. Did it say I may be excommunicated? No, my reputation with the Pope will not be as high as it once was. That's alright. Fucking squeaky chair. Sound like a fart, but it wasn't. I did build siege agreement. Yeah, I did. Okay, good. That should be an easy win, even without a general.
Off the boat at once. Who do I face? Yes.
Hang on. Which way do we have to go down? Ah, shit.
We march.
Probably could have gone around this way. Well, this way at least we'll meet up with our buddies up this way. So that should be fine. What else?
Combining the fleets.
Let's merge them because I can't be bothered.
Yes. Yes, man. Your orders? Yes.
Well, let's just hope they keep them safe until we get to. I don't know. We can go to Dublin first, or maybe straight to London. London's worth more.
Come on.
Okay, so we got Magdeburg up here, or what's this? Nuremberg. Nuremberg is less defended. We should go to Nuremberg first. Fuck the Pope. How bad is it? Barely even noticed.
When shall we attack the wars then, my lord? Your orders.
They didn't give us any notifications about Poland. Okay, we can't just sit here either. We need to go north.
Command me. Yes.
So leave behind these. And let's head north.
Continuing tomorrow, bringing these lands under your gaze.
So, 61 territories. Alright, so let's do Alexandria first.
Right,
Could probably auto resolve this. And you know what? I think I will. Oh, that was shit. Could've done way better than that. And I think at this point here, I just want to get to, like, the Mongols. Ah, look at this. Damage shit everywhere. What's this? Theologian's Guild? Fuck off with that crap. Go to the Merchant's Guild or something like that. Okay, leave behind a Balkan Archer and then we're heading straight for Cairo. Maybe not. Okay, so the stuff that's damaged, this provides 10% public order, so that'll get us to 60, that'll get us to 65. Someone's going to have to stay behind. How come all you guys have got so much fucking chivalry? Great Crusader, right. Okay, so which of you has the most chivalry? You can stay behind.
Of course, my lord. Let me strike, my lord. Approaching, my lord.
Ooh, large stone walls. Hope you don't mind me taking that. Fuck all.
Sooner or later, they will relent, my lord. When shall we attack the walls, then?
Alright, let's do this. This will probably have to be fought manually.
Yes,
yeah.
Lord. Closing for battle.
Ooh, actually, no, not necessarily. It's just a general's bodyguard. They perform, like, shit in auto resolve. This is the auto resolve episode. But the thing is, I do know how the auto resolve works in this game. And certain units don't perform well in auto resolve, so. Yay. Anyway, fighting small battles like this, I'm sure no one's really interested in that kind of stuff. Oh, what happened here? I'll just dump that tax. I want to get to the Mongols now, because there's no other real threat left in the campaign. So you just wait there until he shows up, and then you can go meet up with him. Them being there is not really a good thing, but it'll be fine.
Your orders? Plotting course now, my lord.
What now?
Your orders, number one.
Was I supposed to do that last turn? I don't think so.
Your orders, number one. We will engage them.
Okay, we won't fight this order. Let's do it manually.
We shall claim victory in God's name, men! To battle!
It's funny, in those videos that I made about Total War Warhammer's auto resolve being broken, people have been saying stuff like, oh, but Medieval 2's auto resolve was broken as well. It's like, no, it's not. It actually works perfectly. It's supposed to be random. You're not supposed to be able to just predict from an auto resolve whether or not you're going to win. I mean, in an even match. It should punish laziness on big scale battles, but it should at the same time, those battles that I just didn't feel like playing because the odds were way in my favor, it just wasn't worth doing, it would take me like 10 minutes each battle, just auto resolved, got through it. I probably could have done a bit better had I fought it manually, but that's the price of laziness. And since this isn't a blitz campaign or anything like that, or not even a challenge campaign, I'm just doing this because I want to have fun. It doesn't matter. So who are you getting shot by? Oh, just the towers. It'll be alright. So they lost 25 men on the approach there. Well, actually a bit more than that, but that's nothing.
The battering ram has done its work. Now is the time for brave hearts.
And they got loads of cavalry. Fairly light cavalry, so it would be good if we put a stop to them.
Give grace to God.
Well, we're gonna put a stop to everything.
Captured the enemy's walls.
Ah, you son of a bitch. These guys aren't good against cavalry, but then again, they're not good against anything, so... Really, already? Right, well, while they're fighting, let's cut them off from the town square.
But our men are winning the battle and forging a worthy victory.
Come on, hurry up. Okay, we hit them in the rear. Ah, oh, very nice. This made the battle go very, very well. Look at all those captives. You didn't quite get them all, so you deserve to be killed for that. Okay, Bulgarian brigands, get your ass over here. Badly blooded. They have lost half their men. You guys have done your part, don't worry about doing anything further. The general will finish them off, and then we'll just shoot him.
It is unwise to praise the day before sunset, but our men are winning the battle and forging a worthy victory.
So yeah, we just put them up on the wall and shoot them. I mean, we could just send an all-out melee in there, but that's the stupid thing to do. Why sacrifice men's lives unnecessarily? I mean, these men here, they're dead no matter what. They can't survive this battle. But these men here, they can fight on to live another day, or even survive the war in total. And go home and live their stupid peasant lives however the fuck they want. Until time comes for me to draft their sons into the next war against the Mongols. But then again, the thing about the Mongols is they come to us. We have to defend our territory against the Mongols. We have to defend Europe against the Mongols. We can't just decide, oh no, we shouldn't go to war with them. Because that's the real war. The war against the Mongols. Including the Timurids, of course, which are Mongols. Okay, so maybe they're not all dead. But they're all defeated. You see, my conquest is really about saving lives. Think about the aftermath. After everything has been conquered. You know, no more wars between France and Germany, or between France and England, or England and Scotland, and wars and Spanish, and Spanish and Portuguese, and Turks and Byzantines, all of that's over. Just centuries of peace. Well, at least a couple of years of peace.
Your orders, number one.
Alright, so let's leave behind, you know, Balkan archers, because they're shit. And we'll head up this way.
We shall continue at first light, establishing it.
And those will try and catch up if they can. But that's a pretty good settlement there. I guess. I mean, it is a castle. Yeah, actually, let's build the roads. So now we've got 64 settlements. That's right, you guys need to wait there until we get a few more troops. Who haven't I used yet? I think that's everyone. Alright then, let's construct stuff. So Venice is looking pretty good. Needs more population growth. I mean, I could just drop the taxes, but that's making me like 500 a turn, which I can use to reinvest into more construction. Just, I guess invest into crop rotation. increase the taxes here and there because we need the money to now invest into more construction. Sure, it does lower population growth, but I got a lot of things to construct. Kiev. The mines at Kiev provide... Oh, no, that's garbage. We need public order here anyway. That's not too bad. We'll go with that. Okay, like I said, Odessa... been a little bit problematic. Oh, we almost... Yes, we've got enough money to build in every settlement. That's good. And with a little bit left over. And now we're going to make 19,000 on the next turn. So when's this next fucking crusade coming? Well, it's not going to come soon if they're not happy with this. Well, it's been what, 4 or 5 turns since we took Jerusalem? Maybe longer than that. I'm trying to backtrack. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. About 5 turns, I think. Alright, moving on. Aw, motherfucker, I knew I was forgetting someone. I need to not lay siege there.
Laying siege.
Greetings.
Because they'll sally out and I'll get stomped. No.
You are not farewell then, my lord.
I didn't have a bunch of guys around here that were making their way. Yeah, these. Up north you go.
Yes.
Okay, so what we need to do here is firstly have them stand here. Then, what do I need? So you besiege, don't build any equipment. Okay, so we're going to be up against Scythicon. Okay. I'll need just one load of Turkopoles should be enough. Because all I need to do is take out the Scythicon, that'll probably be the general, and then the rest of this should be easy. You've got lots of dread, don't you? No, don't have any. If I bring any more, they probably won't sally out. Relations improved. Well, didn't look like it, but that's fine. Something to do now.
Let me strike, my lord.
This army here should be capable of taking out Russia.
Approaching, my lord. Stopping for the night. Bringing these lands under your gaze. Who do I face?
I think I might order a resolve this one. A large town, I just don't feel like it. Oh, good stuff.
Victory! We march through your enemy streets. Victory!
Alright, good. So we just need to leave behind one unit. This is almost all mercenaries now, apart from the cavalry. I think leaving behind the Crusader sergeants would be wise. So we've got a Polish town up here, Prague. Or we can go to the Imperial Castle of Innsbruck. Innsbruck it is.
We march for now.
No, fool. Send your emissary to me.
Yes.
Okay, London or Carnarvon? London it is.
Full sail.
Okay, I want more ships.
Continue tomorrow, my lord.
Do I need more troops? Maybe, but not urgently.
Command me. Yes. Continuing tomorrow.
Okay, good, yes. They make it. How many troops do you need?
Name thy enemy, lord.
You're going to need 9.
Orders. Yes. Your majesty.
Okay,
orders.
Good.
My lord. Merging armies. Who do I face?
Okay, cool. It'll take them a very long time to get down there, but shouldn't be a problem.
Your orders, noble one.
Hellich. Alright, we'll just follow the road.
Yes. Your orders, noble one. Of course, my lord. Yes.
And Cairo here. Jeez, need I say it? Looks like another order resolve. Because I can get away with it now that I've got much larger armies. And generals with lots of command, which does actually make a big difference. See, this guy won't perform for shit, but they might. Yeah, see, I took a bit of damage, but it's fine.
We show little mercy. They deserve none. There stood no chance. I have silenced them.
Alright then, so... Yeah, repair... What's that? Master Theologian's Guild. Alright, I'll keep that, because it's a Master's Guild. And what else? Yep. Council church. Actually, no. We need the church. Whoops. And then the rest of you. Hang on. We need to keep moving. Who are we leaving behind?
Your Majesty.
Probably the Balkan archers. Alright. And then. We keep going south. I wouldn't worry about Crown Prince Moosey. Let's just make our way down here. And then maybe from here we'll travel to here and get a ship and go to Jeddah, maybe. I think we've got enough cavalry. Yeah, get the drill square, why not? Okay, Odessa is still at 70%, but that'll fix things up. It's pretty much guaranteed to fix it. We've still only got one cardinal in reserve.
Command me. Your orders, noble one. Who do I face?
Okay, what else did they do? I don't think there is much. I mean, that's already moved. That's been moved. This guy's ready to go. Okay, we've got public order issues here in Smyrna, because I think I converted this to a large town. But we can fix it. Oh, there's no Catholicism here.
Yes.
Right, let's just get to construction. Bit of a quiet episode this turn, I think. Corinth doesn't really need to be a castle. But we'll just leave it be a castle, it's fine. What kind of money do we make from mining here? Absolute dog shit. And that's just fucking horse shit, even more so. But nothing else is going to make much money, except for that. I mean, that's not going to make much more, but at least it provides some population growth. Doesn't it have good mining here? No. Well, the public order's under control, so we've already built the first church. I'll train another priest. And just go with the farming. Need the population growth. Okay, no, that's not very much. It just looks like it's a lot just because this region's poor as shit. Okay, good. I managed to construct everything and still have some money left over. That's great. I guess I'm not... Since I'm not recruiting too many more troops, it's not getting over bloated. How's this region making no money? Just because I put on daily races. Oh, it's very corrupt. I see. Well, I mean, I could make money if I put on monthly races. And yeah, I'd probably be able to get away with that, so that should be fine. Let's move on. Looking for a big fight, you know, not just little city fights with, like, three garrison units. Okay, here we go. Yep. So, we just focus on him. If we get rid of him, the rest of it should be easy. One of the most requested campaigns I get for Medieval 2 is usually Byzantine Empire. I don't know why. I would think the Byzantine Empire would be not really that interesting because, for one thing, they don't have crusades, and they're not weak at all. They're very strong. Okay, balance of power. Massively not in our favor. But that's fine. It's just a balance of power. It doesn't mean anything. The tactics are in our favor. Against Scythicon, it would be best if we can get into melee with them, but the chances of us actually being able to catch them are going to be slim to none, which is why I've brought these. If they're busy shooting my general, then you can get a few shots on. But then again, my general just caught him in combat, so never mind. Just have to beat him before their infantry get here. I have to mow through them as quickly as I can. When am I going to get another chance to bloody kill this guy? Just got to keep going. Our general is not even bloody at all, so that's good. Okay, excellent. That's what we needed. Our men have slain the enemy general. Now his men will. Okay, now there are other archers shooting at us. They need to be dealt with, like Turkish javelin men and Trebizond archers. They need to be defeated. problems. So what do we got over here? Two loads of Turkish javelin men. Shit. You should get back. I need to be getting rid of these peasants. Yeah, I thought they might shoot him. Are these the Trebizond? No, Turkish javelin men. Because the thing is, the Turkish javelin men are actually... they're not good in melee, but they're decent, like reasonable. Tell you what, it'd really benefit you to get a bit more dread. Oops. You need to be need to be shooting the spear militia. He's not doing anything because he doesn't have a clear line of sight to where they're going. They're really not listening to me at the moment. Big delays on these orders, but that's okay. We've pretty much got them, I'd say. With their general dead, what can they do? I probably didn't even need this guy, but good to have him just in case. Kind of annoying when you can't actually run them down when they just break instantly all the time. Well, maybe we can. Let me just try something. If he opens the gate for us, we can run them down.
Only half the enemy force remains.
What are these here? Peasant archers? Yep, run them down.
God save us! The enemy have the walls!
God, I thought that saved my general got killed.
Defense, or all will be lost. Our army is tiring.
Alright, now you need to get the fuck out of here.
Our men are in command of the castle!
The only reason we came in here was to run down all those troops. I didn't actually want to stay. We're still much better off fighting them out here. Well, except if they're already routing. Get out of here. As soon as we get all of our troops out, they'll come back out at us. Spear. What are these? More spears and archers. Okay. So, spearmen, we should be trying to shoot with our archers a little bit. I'm sure they're pretty damn exhausted. We could probably get a mass route going. We just charge right into them. That should break them. There we go. And if we could just roll up the line, we should be done here.
For the moment, the fortune of battle goes our way. It is unwise to praise the day before sunset, but our men are... Praise the Almighty!
Yeah, keep running them down once you get experience.
Our enemy has lost his stomach to fight. We must push our advantage.
Alright, we're done here.
The enemy are...
The day is ours. The enemy are beaten.
Okay, you need to learn how to be a total asshole so you can exterminate them.
Command me. Yes, marching. Stopping for the night. Bring
good.
These lands under your gaze.
All Okay, now we need to try and find a way to drop these races as soon as possible. Obviously hiring some militia will certainly help. Not much though, because there's already a huge population here. But we really need are priests, because the biggest problem I think is that religious unrest. That'll help a bit.
Who do I face?
Okay, now Jerusalem has massive public order problems. What the fuck happened here? They must have chucked in like a bunch of spies. Okay, well if he's providing 15% public order, they're going to provide an additional 30. And that'll get us there, plus that'll help as well. So we should be okay. Okay, we just need to leave someone behind here. Let's see. You, and then we just keep moving on. It's good that now the Turks are gone, because it's so much easier to fight rebels. Less interesting, but easier.
Approaching, my lord. Can't be here, my lord. Name thy enemy, lord. Yes.
So when's this next crusade available? Not yet. Nice they've left Russia undefended. Well, Novgorod. I should say poorly defended, like I wouldn't say it's undefended. Oh, this guy's just in the way. So, push him out of the way. Okay, Halych. Okay, now, normally I would just do the thing where I put my general here and the rest of the army here, because that's a big garrison in there, but it's a castle. It would be a lot more fun, I think, to fight this the traditional way. Fuck traditions, but that's what we're going to do. We don't need cavalry, we're going to need a lot of spearmen, and we've got plenty of archers. These guys might come in handy during the fight. There's a lot of troops in there. Well, we'll just do the same with that as well. Give them the same courtesy of killing them in their homes.
When shall we attack the walls then, my lord?
Next turn, you stupid shit. Alright, next we land here in, what's it called? Wessex? I don't know. The fuck are you doing here blocking my way into the fucking settlement, you cunt? Bloody right, you better get out of my way. Alright, so London, only basic militia there, that's easy. What have they got here? Theologians Guild, we need to destroy that.
Yes. Combining the fleets. Blockading trade to this port.
Command me. Men,
it's going to take a long time to get down there.
Stopping for the night. Bringing these lands under your gaze.
Okay, we're almost at a full stack here. I think we can justify leaving. I don't want peasants. I will get some more knights there. They'll catch up to us. Leave behind these peasants, even though we've got smaller units. That's why I hired those peasants, was to leave them behind. To maintain public order. Now, Baghdad, that's our next destination. If we manage to take Baghdad, then we've got the easternmost settlement in the game, with the exception of Volga Borga, whatever. Whatever the fuck it's called.
Who do I face? Command me.
How old is our faction leader?
Name thy enemy, Lord.
Now, he could die at any moment. That sucks. There's no ancient or medieval. I would say Genghis Khan actually conquered more than this in a lifetime. But Europe's more valuable than Asia. And this guy's pretty much conquered the entire Roman Empire. And there's a few things that were part of the Roman Empire that we don't have, like Britannia. We don't have Libya, I think. few things that... Oh, yeah, whatever. I never got this far up north. He's not dead yet. Okay, I think that's all I can do. Alright, let's get to construction. I don't have much money this turn, because I did hire quite a few mercenaries. Cool, that's worth a decent amount of cash. I'm not gonna have enough money to get through everything this time. I'm still making a lot of money per turn. Okay, the next crusade should be available within probably 3 or 4 turns. But then again, I'll have to bribe the Pope before I do that, but that's okay. I mean, how many Catholic factions are left? 5 other Catholic factions. I'm just thinking if we can lower that number down by 2 or 3. Probably not. I mean, there's still quite a few Holy Roman Empire bastards running around. Poland, there's quite a bit left to do with them. We haven't even started on Denmark, and we've only just started on the English. Right, moving on. They're very forgettable, those losers. The Danes declare war on me? Insufferable. How dare they? What have they got anyway? Well, whatever they've got, there's no way in hell pilgrims are going to defend against it. It's fine. Have they built anything? No. So they'll hold that siege for another turn. Maybe I should have gone after them when I was there, but, you know, then I wouldn't have Nuremberg and Innsbruck. Well, I haven't got it yet, but I'm going to get it. Not today, though. We're going to go after London, and then I feel like I need a break. I actually feel like I'm quite tired, and that's probably the reason why I'm a little bit lazy with the auto-resolves today. I'll fight this battle manually, and then, yeah, I think I better call that a day. Alright, how are we going to deal with this? First things first, let's reorganize, because this is a bloody mess, as usual. Okay, I don't actually have that many melee infantry, it's all bloody archers. Which is fine, because... whatever. Let me get the archers up on the ladders. Yeah, I think I'm actually really tired. Because I'm just like, I just want to be lazy about it. You ever get that feeling when you're playing a game, you just realize, maybe I should have gone to bed instead. That's what I feel like right now. The thing is, I've already committed to doing this episode, so I'm just like, oh, I've got another 10 more minutes I gotta do. I can't just turn it off now, just because I'm tired. Sleep and I'm dead. So what if I've been awake 18 hours? Doesn't matter. Typical. Alright, now these are all melee troops, aren't they? Spear militia, and what's the other one over here? Is that not more spear militia or is it town militia? Oh, it's a town militia, alright. I want you guys in there, go after the town militia to make sure they don't get back to the town square. Two of our guys here should be able to terrify them.
Our men have reached the gate with the battering ram. The battering ram has done its work. Now is the time for brave hearts and brave deeds.
I kind of can't be bothered to use the archers in this one, so I'm just going to go straight melee.
Give grace to God. We have captured the enemy's walls.
These guys here, not allowed to get back to the town square. Actually, they're not getting off the walls, so we'll just keep an eye on them, but... Hey, come over here. You'll help terrify him. He's already shaken.
It is unwise to praise the day before the enemy general has no honor. He
flees
the field of battle and abandons his men.
He and I have something in common. We both have no honor, except I'm a winner, and he's fucking loser.
The Lord above is kind. We have captured. Praise the saints. Our men have taken control of the city.
More spear militia coming this way. We've got them cut off, so what are they going to do? Oh, never mind. Hey, just stay where you are, it's fine.
My lord, we have lost control of the city.
Okay, get back over here because...
It is unwise to pray
here they come.
Before sunset, but our men are winning the battle and forging a world.
I really want to play that new Call of Warhammer mod. What's it called? Beginning of the End Times. That looks awesome.
Please, the battle. Run down.
Probably will have started the Let's Play campaign by the time you guys watch this episode, because this is episode, 15? And I've released up to episode 3 so far. So, yeah. It's... I probably would have started something by then, by now, whatever. Ooh, ransom. Oh.
Surely you'd rather coin than captives, my lord.
12. Convince me.
Let us live, sire. Please.
Don't beg to me.
No, please, my lord. Reconsider.
I could use a ransom, but I don't want to. Have you guys seen the director's cut of Kingdom of Heaven, where their party captured one of the lords, and the guy's like, "I'm the son of I'm accorded the right of ransom," and then they just fucking crack him over the head with like a pick. I was like, "Yes, that's how you deal with cunts." Anyway, guys, that's the end of this episode. So like and subscribe. Part 16 is next, and don't forget to visit me on Facebook. See you next time, fuckers.